Previously on 4 Idiots.
We've got 16 days to go around 13 countries with 5 of us in one motorhome. What's going to go wrong?
Currently, we have completed almost half of our 3,000-mile road trip, and we celebrated with a bar crawl in Venice, which got completely out of hand.
I know we're all drunk, but put the f***ing pallet down.
Meaning we were now behind schedule. And aside from the jaw-dropping scenery, things aren't going to improve much for us during this episode, with a number of issues that will really test our ability to complete this challenge. As well as myself, David, the geography expert and filmmaker of the trip, there's Badger, head of hospitality, Jamie, main driver, Ethan, co-pilot, and Wynne, who basically just gets to live life as a dog for 2 weeks. This is 4 Idiots Series 4, the ultimate European road trip. I'd only scheduled 3 hours in Venice, but by the time we got back to the motorhome, it was 4:45 in the morning. Everybody was completely gone and we desperately needed to catch up on sleep, meaning that half of the day would be wasted. And we pick up the action later that afternoon as we headed out of Venice on the next leg of our trip towards Croatia, Slovenia, and then the Dolomites. But unfortunately, it seemed like not everyone had recovered yet.
We were absolutely mortal in Venice. We talked to everyone, made friends with everyone, everyone liked
it. Are you still drunk?
Yeah.
Jamie then decided to check his phone for videos to try and bring back some memory.
Look at this.
Really, really drunk. As you can tell.
What the fuck?
Oh shit, is that the police?
Oh shit, man, oh,
is that the Italian roses in front? Sit down.
Are you awake now? Are you back with us? Back with the world?
I tell you what, I'll be awake when we jump in the Mediterranean Sea.
Oi, oi.
I was just looking before, like when we get down to Pula in Croatia, which is the furthest point that we'll be away from the UK on the journey, we'll have travelled around about a tenth of the way across the world.
Really?
Yeah.
Bloody hell.
To get to Croatia, we did have to briefly pass through Slovenia. But don't worry, we'll be heading back there later.
3, 2, 1. Hello and welcome to Croatia. Or rather, Hrvatska, as it's actually called in Croatian. Filming location of Game of Thrones. Woo! Home of the Dalmatian dog breed. The most remains of Neanderthals in the world have also been found here. There are still, however, active mines dotted about from the Yugoslavian war, so beware if you walk off path. The longest word in Croatian is Prijestolonajedinikovicisinima, which means little heiress apparent to the throne. We're currently heading for Pula, which is in the northwest of the country, and its amphitheatre is one of only 3 of its type that are still preserved in the world, and gladiators actually used to fight in it. So welcome to Croatia and enjoy our short day here.
Woo! Yeah!
Yes!
Whoa! Oh my god, look! Whoa! Oh, look at that! Whoa! Wow!
Unfortunately, we were told motorhomes aren't allowed to park in the car parks near the amphitheatre, so we just had to keep on driving towards our campsite.
There's a lot of graffiti, like a hell of a lot of graffiti. Is this a rough town?
Luckily though, our campsite was in the nice part of town.
Wow, look at that, man. Look at it. Look at it with your eyes.
Oh yeah, no, it is nice here.
Alright guys, welcome to another edition of 32nd campsite at the side of the road tours. This one is called Arena Stoja campsite. It's literally right on a little peninsula, right next to the big wet thing that is the Med. There's plenty of pictures. There's a restaurant, there's some toilet and shower blocks. I think there's about three dotted around. There's other sorts of accommodation as well, other than obviously just campers. Seems quite reasonably priced. And yeah, it's in a great location, literally 10 minutes from Pula.
He's coming to get food.
Badger, talk to us about what is before our eyes here.
Before our eyes. So I made some Greek flatbreads, which is just a mixture of yogurt and flour. An arrangement of dry cured meats. That stuff there, I believed to have melted, but it doesn't. It's actually a bit more like halloumi. Steak fajitas, and you've got a mixture of peppers, onions, and carrots.
Oh, wow.
You coming in?
I want to eat it.
How are they?
After dinner, I cleaned the motorhome for the 500th time, and the kids went for a midnight play outside.
What you got there? Bombs away, boy! Get across!
The next morning, we all woke up with the same idea: jump in the Med and sunbathe. But before this, we had to answer a very important question. At what point does a road become a path? And can you fit a six-berth motorhome down it?
What's the dimensions in the motorhome?
Width 275 and the height is 3.
Somehow I don't think we're going to be able to make it.
Those trees look really low.
Jamie, you might hit that.
Survival tips with Badger. Yeah. No. No. Here's another one. Hold it! Hold it, Badger!
Now reverse back into there.
That boy's on me.
We are on your position.
Full lock, full lock. Swivel, swivel.
Stop.
F***ing cyclists!
Well, we've taken up the entire road and the cyclists aren't very happy.
No, I'm not surprised.
But when are they ever?
Meanwhile.
My boys keep coming.
Yeah, they don't stop coming and they don't stop coming.
Grab that. Grab that.
Wait.
Yep, go. Go.
Keep going.
Hello.
You're not having a very good day, are you?
No!
Luckily though, our efforts of getting to this parking spot were rewarded.
How good's this?
Wow.
Oh, what a finder.
Very nice.
What a finder.
Woo! Yes, lad!
Nice, isn't it? Come on, boys.
Hi.
How are you?
Just you and me. Summertime, get ready, we are slowly divine. No water and the air say, let's live our dream. Summertime, get ready, we are slowly divine. No water and the air say, just you and me. Summertime, get ready, we are slowly divine. No water and the air say, let's live our dream.
After our two pilots burnt themselves, we decided to hit the road and headed to our next country.
Hello everybody, and welcome to Slovenia. Did you know that Slovenia covers less than 0.004% 5% of the world's surface, it's about the same size as Wales, and that there is one vineyard for every 75 people. In fact, the oldest vineyard in the world that still produces grapes can be found here, now over 400 years old. There are over 10,000 caves in Slovenia, so hopefully we might see one. There are 27,000 kilometers of streams and rivers in the country, making it an excellent place for water activities like rafting. More than 61% of the total land area is covered in... Everything's fell over here. Jamie, slow. More than 61% of the total land area is covered in forest, and it's one of the only countries in the world where this area is actually expanding. However, I do need to make you aware, as the geography and David Attenborough figure on our trip, that the region we're heading to now does have a population of brown bears, with a population of around 600 or 700 across the whole country. According to the people who study animals, they are now mostly vegan and have caught up with the times. However, they can quite easily be succumbed to some nice lamb for Sunday lunch. And if they're feeling extremely peckish and you're in the wrong place at the right time, I'd run. In late 2019, brown bears did kill 3 people in Romania, but this was a rare occurrence. So just bear that in mind if you go for a shit in the woods, but hopefully we'll have a safe trip in Slovenia. Thank you.
So with the intro done, we drove onwards into a country which, aside from our textbook facts, none of us really knew anything about.
Hell of a lot of forest,
like,
isn't there?
Yeah.
F*** me.
Whoa.
What?
I told you it's here, boys!
Whoa!
Oh yeah, baby!
This was... Wow!
What the... That's a weird colour.
That's why I brought us here.
That's a weird colour.
That is why I brought us here.
That is an odd colour.
Look at that.
It looks fake.
Absolutely unbelievable.
Very angry, the weather outside, the atmosphere.
Whoa! Shit!
Damn, this does not look like Europe.
With the light fading, a gigantic storm brewing, and no campsite booked, we decided that because we wanted to go rafting first thing tomorrow, the best option was to find a secluded spot near the river.
Whoa!
And as we were off-grid with limited water, there was only one way to shower.
David's having a shower in the rain. Because it's chucking it down there. I mean, like, right here, you could get a nice shower.
I know.
That's exactly what I did.
Whoa! Oh,
me. It's not bad. I've just washed my hair. I've genuinely just washed my hair.
It looks like he's in my life. I'm a little rouge.
I'm in quite a lot of pain.
Yeah, it's bad. There is aftersun in there.
I just love it, right, how there's bears. What did you say? 800 bears or something like that?
Something like that.
And if you care to look on the bench, you'll see the bait ready for the bear.
The
was
food?
Pork?
Yes.
Well, when we shut the door, they're not going to be able to smell that, are they?
Oh, no, keep the door open.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Are you kidding?
Are you mad? The easiest way to deterrent a bear is by flicking it on its nose.
Oh, yeah, you get that close. Go right up to his face and just...
If
go
a
bear, away,
if
now,
a,
bear.
If a bear comes there, I'll flick its nose till the dog bleeds.
I don't believe a flick of a bloody really big bear.
It does. It's sensitive as f**k. It smells, it senses, everything like that from the nose. Flick its f**king nose and tell it it's a bad boy and it'll f**k off down the river.
I didn't know you were such a bear expert.
Yeah.
He's after not a bear expert, he just said to flick a bear's nose.
Right, hang on, this is how much of a bear expert I am. David, open the bottom of that cupboard there, the one underneath the fridge.
Oh, we've got honey in there, haven't we? Oh, yeah. Big bottle of honey.
Now look at the size of the Mr. Bear wants to come out with some honey. I can entertain him all day long. Snake!
What? What?
Snake.
What?
Snake.
What are you...
Is it really?
Holy shit, what the hell is that? What the hell is that? What the f**k is that?
It's a snake. Hello, my name's Mr. Bear. Have you got any honey? Oh no.
We need to lock this, Jamie.
Do we?
Yeah, we need to lock
this. I'm fine. I'm friends with bears. Raw. Come on, Mr. Bear, come in.
Raw.
Time for tea, what?
Raw.
Raw. He wants to really do the raw.
Yeah. Do the raw.
I knew you were going to say that.
Do a big raw. Wake him up.
Raw!
Didn't wake him up.
I think he's awake.
Early the next morning, we were in fact woken up by a loud disturbance. It wasn't a bear, however, it was the Slovenian police, who fined us and another van €40 for camping in an illegal spot. And since Badger gave them my passport to put against the charge, I can now say that I'm the only person I know who has a criminal record in Slovenia. In hindsight though, it was definitely worth it for the amazing location, and it did also get us up early for our next activity.
We're going rafting, boys! Your captain's taking you on this one.
I would be really enthusiastic if we weren't woken up by police at half seven in the morning, after going to bed really late every single night.
Yeah.
Have any of you got life jackets?
No.
Just wear that.
Yeah, I know.
The plan was that me, Badger and Jamie would sail to an exit point and car park further down the river, where Ethan would be there to pick us up. And with all of this clearly explained to Wynn, we headed off on our voyage.
Hello and welcome to the river.
Wow, we're moving, boys.
Unfortunately though, the water levels seemed to be a bit low.
Badger, are you going to do anything about this situation? Oh, my knees. Ow, ow.
He's taking a photo of us.
A Slovenian man is taking a photo of us.
Why is he taking a photo of us?
Do you think it's because he knows what's coming up?
Badger, man, you're shit at paddling. You're going the wrong way, mate. Badger can't bloody be captain.
Ah, shit.
Mike, ah, bloody trees everywhere. Holy shit.
Badger. Which way are you aiming to go here? Should we go left or right?
Left.
Left? You want to go left?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Oh, no.
Oh, this wasn't...
Oh, my God.
This wasn't in the pool.
Oh, my God. Hold on, boys. Whoa. This is dangerous now.
What did I tell you to lift?
Paddle, lift.
Rock in the ship.
Rock, big rock.
Lean.
Get us off it.
Go.
Oh, that's cold.
Oh, shit. There's other people paddling down there.
There's a lot of them. And we've got to act like we know what we're doing.
Woo!
Oh, wait, man, you make this look like tits.
Oi, oi.
Hey, oi. Why is everyone staring at us? What are we doing wrong?
Once the water flow calmed, though, it was a joyous experience.
Oh, this is beautiful, boys.
This extremely peaceful moment was then disturbed by an incoming rainstorm and then a worrying phone call from Wynn.
Yes, so, basically Ethan can't drive.
What?
Yeah, I think he might be dying.
Wynn explained that it seemed like heat stroke, and that also, to add to this, one of the windows had jammed open, meaning that even if Ethan came round, the motorhome would be too dangerous to drive with the window sticking out. We leave them for 10 minutes and everything's gone to shit.
Oh, sailor, went to sea.
I'm trying to spin us around your
tits. There's the exit, there's the exit.
Where?
Red rafts.
Oh,
red rafts.
Look at that. Bloody iceberg in the middle of, well, a rock iceberg in the middle of the river there.
Oh, it's like Titanic.
Avoid that. Just all you've got to do is avoid that.
I'm lying, I'm lying.
The one thing that I said to avoid, and we're about to hit it.
Jack!
We didn't really document the next part very well, but Badger courageously ran all the way back to the motorhome, saved Ethan, and then set about sorting out the window. Me and Jamie, meanwhile, were just left waiting and praying, with no contact and nothing but the raft for survival.
Hello,
and welcome to Standing on the Side of the Road.
In Slovenia.
In Slovenia. I've been doing this for an hour.
What did they just ask?
It's alright, thank you very much, though.
What did they just ask?
Asking for
what? Really? Wait, well, what if they can't get the window down?
They must be able to fix it. They have to close the window.
The window has to get closed, otherwise we can't continue on the trip.
Thankfully, after some more anxious waiting, they arrived.
Oh. Here.
Yes!
It's Carl Banks at the helm.
But our colleague was in a bad way. I think Slovenia had probably had enough of us by now, so we made our way back into Italy, heading towards the Dolomites, which would be the next point of interest on our route. After a couple of hours, Ethan started to come round a bit, which gave us a chance to catch up with him.
So what happened in your world today then, Ethan?
Well, I was rudely disturbed this morning by some police officers. I'll be real with you. Not entirely sure what happened there, but seemingly it was dealt with. So that's cool. I then felt quite like shit as I hadn't slept at all. Any which way I decided to lean was pain. Yeah, I was just getting a bit of shut eye, you know. You guys f***ed off to a river somewhere. And left me in the RV with Wynn. Now, I needed a piss. I got up, made it to the toilet, relieved myself of about a gallon and a half of piss, and then immediately after pissing, the whole room went black. Oh. And I felt like I was going to vomit and shit myself simultaneously. And then I fell face first into the sink.
Oh.
Which Wynn didn't notice. So after regaining consciousness for about 5 minutes, I then crawled out and went, Wynn, I need you to listen to me very carefully. I need you to call Badger, and I need water, because I think I might be dying. And then Badger lay me face down on a bed and covered me in Greek yogurt. And here we are.
What I've always wanted to do.
And he didn't even buy us a drink first.
I did put a bottle of water.
Meanwhile, have you ever seen a supermarket with a better view than this? I mean, if my local supermarket had some ex-volcanic landscape with a massive waterfall, I'd be quite happy.
So overall, what would you rate the day?
I'd say it's a solid 2 out of 5. It's been a very mild day, to be honest.
Yeah.
Below average day.
Although the weather had turned a bit grim, as we headed towards the Dolomites, it did make the scenery even more spectacular.
We actually might be hitting clouds before long, for the first time on the trip.
Seen down the valley?
Yeah. Not you, Jamie, you look at the road.
Yeah, please do look at the road.
Thank you. And even when we came into the endless small towns that we passed through, the views were still nothing short of amazing.
It's honestly incredible.
Oh, look at the colour of that water.
Oh my god! Whoa!
Oh, you see it over there?
Well, there's the Pope. There he is, sitting there all day.
That's the Pope. Whoa.
Oh my god. It's just like everywhere is so nice.
After that incredible evening drive, we reached our campsite for the night and scrammed some pizza. And the next morning, we discovered that there are some resident brown bears, although they come in a slightly different form than usual.
Badger, have you seen the brown bears here?
Oh my god, it's a bear. Oh, it's going.
Oh my god.
I've got attacked by a bear.
Hello.
I wish to be attacked by this brown bear.
I did do a 30-second review of this campsite, but to be honest, nothing else really needs to be said other than that it was a great budget-friendly place to spend the night. And the view that you wake up to is what really makes it stand out.
Come and look at the view. Look.
It's
look at this view here.
Oh, it's a nice hill, isn't it?
It is. It's lovely, isn't it?
Yeah, I like the way the trees form on it.
Yeah? Yeah?
I thought you'd me! Holy shit!
That wasn't there before. It was raining.
No, because it was rain. It keeps raining every evening, and then in the morning, you wake up and everything's just cleared up.
Wow.
So we're going up there.
That looks insane.
So we quickly got ready, and after a few minutes of being on the road, we found ourselves in what appeared to be Europe's version of Monument Valley.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Exactly what you would see on a postcard right there.
Postcards, wallpapers.
The distinct rock formation that you could see in the top left corner is where we are heading, Tre Cime di Lavaredo. However, seen as it is a very popular location, we did have to wait in a bit of a queue to get a toll pass for the road that takes you up to the top.
Oh no, we can't watch that.
Oh dear. Oh
f***,
there's the farmer.
Who the f*** is that?
Farmer Giles.
Who the hell's he?
He's coming to break it up.
What the f*** is he wearing?
Have you seen this wolf? That's a shot.
It's a short costume. His is just denim, yours is leather.
Is that a dog?
That's a dog barking. Oh, it's having it.
Oh.
It's having it.
Round about. Look at him go. I'd be scared of that bloody dog.
Soon we got through the queue, and with every meter we climbed, the views got better and better.
Wow! Oh shit, the road is literally vertical.
And by the time we reached the car park, we didn't even know which way to look.
Mate! Holy shit!
Until 1919, the peaks formed part of the border between Italy and Austria-Hungary, meaning that during the First World War, they were part of the Italian front line, and there were numerous battles that happened here.
There's graves there. Are they graves?
Are they graves?
I don't know.
As well as memorials, there are also a few trenches and tunnels around the area too.
I think they're graves, you know, David.
It's hard to see why there was any fighting though, when you've got these views to distract you. Although, the land alone is definitely worth battling for.
To say, I'm lost for words. I need better words.
I'm a f***ing mountain goat. Come on, Wayne. Oi, oi. I'm knackered, man. We haven't had enough rest on this trip to do this.
We're like 4 hours sleep, yeah.
Yeah, 4 hours sleep every night.
Soon, we reach the top of the hiking route.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
It's not bad.
What do you mean it's not bad?
I give it a 5 out of 10.
Are you for real? What are you looking at?
Overall, some of the best landscape I've ever seen.
I've never ever seen anything like it. But the funny thing is, I've said that quite a few times before it is.
But we keep going to better plate, we keep topping them each time.
Surely you can't top this. Look at it.
Once we made it back down, we finished the hike by adding our mark along with everyone else's.
Can you reach?
Why did we pick the shortest person to do this? In socks as well, what a tit.
Our day had been absolutely amazing so far, and then I came up with an idea to make it even more amazing.
Do yous wanna stay in a hotel tonight? Because I've had enough of sleeping on the floor.
Yep.
Are you up for that, mate?
Oh yeah, hell yeah, I am.
Definitely?
Yeah, the sofa is a bit cramped, so yeah.
It didn't take long to find a good looking one.
Oh wow. We've got menu, we'll cross what we want tonight, we'll cross off what we want tonight.
No!
And then we'll hand it to them so they know to prepare it for us. Is there anything there that you like the look of, Badger?
Yeah.
We're going inside a building. Like a proper building.
And we're
going
to stay in it. We're not going to be in a bloody van.
Due to Ethan's incredible pain, he couldn't bear to put a shirt on, which did make our arrival slightly awkward. However, we had managed to get 2 rooms, which meant that he could spend as long as he needed trying to cool the burns down without us being a nuisance.
It's nice. It's got a bunk bed.
Eh? It's like different rooms.
Ooh, there's a balcony.
You could fit like... You fit all of us in this one room, and we've got 2 rooms.
We then headed up to the premium suites.
Oi, oi. Oh man, this has been a long time coming. Going in.
Jesus
Christ.
Oh. No.
What's that?
Holy.
That is a bit weird.
Oh, look at
that. Oh.
What's the bathroom like?
Bloody beautiful. That's a whole shower, a walk-in shower.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Double pisser. Under.
Oh, look, that's where we've just been.
Oh, there's a bag here, boys. What does it say? Dear guests, we are happy to provide you for free with our bathrobes and spa bag during your stay. Yes! I've got a slipper!
Slippers!
The slippers are robes!
Whoa! These are bathrobes. Holy shit.
Boys, we're ruining the place already.
Get the bubbles.
The view that I've got right now from my jacuzzi. Look at that!
Wow. That's the view.
I'm staying here for the rest of my life.
I'm going straight in the pool. There's a rooftop pool.
There's a rooftop pool.
I'm going straight in it.
We're going up to what? The rooftop pool? Apparently? It's so fancy. No way.
Jenny, no shower caps.
No shower caps. We're in Italy and they're not making us wait. There's a church
right there. there's a stick. It's actually brilliant.
I'm going to remember this moment for the rest of my life.
Well deserved.
This is well
that's
good.
Well deserved. No, it is. Well it is very well deserved. Yeah.
It is because we've had a bit of a
this
trek.
This is day 10, the 10th day.
10th day
of living in a motorhome.
Yeah, every single day.
And being like rushed up our asses to like get to. How many countries have we been through now at this point? Like
at least 10.
10.
Is it nice? I'm coming over.
10 days of pure pain.
It's come to an end, boys.
Oh.
As well as the outdoor pool, there was also an indoor one.
What the hell is going on in here?
You gotta see the I'm loving it.
It's the atmosphere is very warm in here.
After we dried off, we went for dinner.
I've never felt so harsh in all my life.
Sorry, that was weird.
Yeah.
You said that both at the same time.
Wow. Because we were thinking the same thing.
Yeah. They said there's a buffet start.
Yeah, and we've already got actual starters. There's pizzas.
David, that's a glass bottle.
The actual starters then arrived.
Parmesan bacon, lemon and mountain flower soup.
Because I'm tasting the mountains of Switzerland.
Very interesting.
And me and Wynne have got some pastry rolls.
That's nice. That is nice.
Yeah.
Next, we were onto the main course.
Veal, sweet potato, puree. There's like a mustardy crust thing, a bit of gravy. And then me and Badger have got swordfish with some Asian salad. What's your overall rating of the meal then? I mean, I know I haven't had dessert yet.
Four out of four idiots. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Top dollar.
After a trio of mini desserts, we headed back up to the room, and Badger had some evening entertainment planned.
You were going?
Yeah.
Nice one. Right. Right, lads, I have an announcement to make. Turn that off.
Turn it off? What off?
Right, boys. I got us a present. Hey! Come on. Hey! Right, boys, wanna know what the present is?
No. Here.
When I was away in sunny Tenerife, I got us our favourite drink for a holiday. Hey! And what is that favourite drink?
Absinthe!
Oh yeah! Absinthe! Woo! Not just any absinthe though. Right, lads, he is watching, right? We go with red on 50%. We then go on green on 70%. Then our usual blue on 80%. And a brand new one, black 85%. If we lose a game, we take a shot. Winnie Boy's just lost a game, so he has to take a shot. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask Mr. Ethan Carbanks to pick a colour without seeing it.
What colours do we have?
I'm not going to tell you.
What's behind door number four?
Behind door number four is green.
Oh, I like it a bit stronger than green.
Okay, what's a bit stronger than green?
I want black.
You want black? Win, you must have really pissed the man off, is all I'm saying. No one's ever had 85% absinthe before, and my God, Win, you're about to have some. Need good playing against yourself, Win, because you ain't getting out of this one, sunshine.
This does bring back traumatic memories of all the lads all day.
It's all down here from hill. No, it's all downhill from here, lads.
Have you had some?
I've had about three so far.
Win
is a top lad. Nah. Win is a top lad. I've just asked Jamie.
That's far too much.
That's less than a shot, you div.
Is it?
Yeah. So I've asked Jamie what colour he wants, and he said black. The strongest I've ever given you is literally a drop of 80, so you go for it, son. Right. Oh, we like to drink with Jamie because Jamie is our mate. And when we drink with Jamie, he dances drinking 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Jamie is a top lad. Na 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 na. Oh, na 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 na.
F me. That's like freaking peril.
Ethan has decided to take the black. I mean, you're burning on the outside, so you might as well burn on the inside as well. Okay. Thanks for the memories, even though they weren't so great.
SpongeBob, me boy, where's me ketamine? Bubbles!
Okay, the bubbles are already going up.
Shit, have you filled it too much?
Yeah, what? Wait, you put bubbles in it!
Oh no.
In a jacuzzi.
Oh shit.
One thing you don't do in a jacuzzi.
Boys, there's a lassie!
Oh no! She'll float.
She floats. She's a floater.
We've had a nice fine dining meal, and now the lads are getting cozy with Rosie in a hot tub.
Cheers.
Oi, oi.
Get some cream between them.
Oh my god, that badger, they're coming home.
Oh no, I can't see my phone anymore.
Shit,
oh, your phone's there. It's getting submerged by
bubbles. Where's the button?
I can't stop.
Where's the button? Where's the button?
Stop, you have a light.
So many
bubbles.
Switch is the button, you're not that impressed. I don't know, I can't find it. No, it's...
No,
they do things.
It's somewhere under there.
You've got to live in luxury. You've got to eat pizza in the jacuzzi. Eat Italian pizza in the jacuzzi.
Go on,
then.
Oh,
the
lovely soft crust, because I'm stuffed.
All right, look. Oh,
f***. We made a terrible mistake.
Yeah, man. Look at where we are.
Boy, I know we're in Italy. It's good, isn't it?
Yeah. Do you know how much this hotel cost?
Mate, what are you doing that for? The bubbles are anywhere but where you're spraying.
I'm clearing the bath.
You're not clearing the bath.
Oh,
how'd you get out of this situation?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
That's it for this part of our European road trip. But coming up next, we're heading to Austria, taking on a high alpine pass where the breathtaking European landscapes continue. And after that, we're hitting up Prague for an epic night out.